As usual, we're going to illustrate this kind of diagrams by using an example. In particular, we're going to describe the state transition diagram for part of our example, for part of our course management system. And we're going to focus on the course offering class. When the class is created, it enters the initialization state, in which the activity performed is to initialize the course. At this point, a simple case is the case in which the class is canceled, so there is a cancel event. And if that happens, the class is simply canceled. So it gets into this final state, which is the state canceled. And the activity in this case is to notify the registered students. Obviously, if this is the flow, there will be no registered students. However, something else can happen when we are in this initial state. So what can happen is that a student can register. So in this case, the add student event is triggered. And the corresponding action is to set the count, in this case will be the count of students for the course offering, to 1. And there will be a change of state, and the course offering will get into this open state. And the action that will be performed on entry will be to register the student. At this point, more students might register, so other student events might occur. And notice that we have a guard here that tells us that this event will trigger this transition only if the count is less than 10. So we're assuming that we're not going to have more than 10 students, just for lack of a better number, in our course offering. So if that happens, if the count is less than 10, so then the count is incremented, so the increment count action takes place, and the system goes back into the open state, and the new student is registered. Now here we have an interesting transition, because there's no event triggering the transition, but simply the fact that the count is equal to 10. So you can imagine this as being a transition that is always enabled, so can always be triggered, but will be guarded by the fact that the count has to be exactly 10. So basically, this transition will take place only when enough students are added, such that we get to count being incremented and being equal to 10, and then the transition will occur, and we will get into the closed state, in which the class is no longer open because there are enough students registered. And at this point, what will happen is that the course will be finalized. So there will be this activity which performs some operation that is needed to finalize the course. Another possibility is that when we are in the open state, the course is canceled. And if the course is canceled, in this case, we go again to the canceled state. But here, the activity of notifying registered students makes more sense, because we will have at least one registered student in this state, and therefore we'll need to notify such student that the course offering has been canceled. Finally, is it possible also to cancel a course after it has been closed? And in this case, again, the same thing will happen. The class will reach the canceled state, and all the students, in this case 10 students, that are registered for the course, will be notified that the course has been canceled. So if we look at this state transition diagram, you can see that it's pretty easy to see what the evolution of objects of this class can be, how they can go from their initial state to various final states, depending on what are the external events that reach the system.